Hi, this is Ram from ramkadem.com. In this lesson, we are going to learn the basic concepts of databases. We will understand what is a database, why do we need it, and what is RDBMS exactly. What is a database? In the industry, when people say database, they can mean two different things. Database can be the actual server that keeps our data, the machine that runs our database program, and the formal definition of a database is a method which we are using in order to store our information. We can use different approaches to store data. We can store our data inside a text file. We can store it in some kind of a hierarchy. For example, think about your operating system. You can access a file by browsing through different folders and subfolders. And a very common method to save our information is using tables. The SQL language interacts with databases that keeps their information inside tables. Now, this presentation is not about making you an expert on database methods. What's important is that you will understand that keeping data inside a table is just one of many methods to store data. People tend to think that a database must save information in the form of a table. I just wanted to make you understand that it doesn't have to be this way. Moving on. Why do we need to use a database such as SQL Server or Oracle? Why don't we just use a notepad to keep all of the company's information? We just said that saving data in a notepad is also a way to store information. When we are using a dedicated database program, such as SQL Server or MySQL, we are getting many benefits. It's way more efficient to write or read from an enterprise-ready database. Databases also provide enhanced security, different options to recover in case of failure, and many more benefits. RDBMS. The method of storing data inside tables is called RDBMS. All of the enterprise-ready database programs, such as Oracle, SQL Server, or MySQL, use tables as a method for storing information. RDBMS stands for Relational Database Management System. Let me show you an example of storing data inside tables. Say we have a company with employees and departments. Each employee is assigned to a different department. Steven, for example, is working at Department 50, and as you can see, Department 50 is the sales department. If you take a closer look, you will see that there is a redundant piece of information. The department name appears both in employees and departments. How can we solve this problem? Instead of repeating the same column twice, we will remove it from the employees table, and by creating a logical connection between the departments and employees tables using the department ID column, we can find the department name of each employee. This is very efficient because if we had millions of rows inside the employees table, we wouldn't have to repeat the department name for each employee. Instead, each department name is only mentioned once at the department table. And as we said, we can always join the information of both tables using the common column department ID. RDBMS is characterized by three main concepts. Each table can be related to another table using the common column, for example, the department ID, as we just saw. This is why we are calling this model the Relational Database Management System. Next, tables should be normalized. It simply means that other than the common column, the department ID in our case, each table should have its own unique set of columns. As we saw, the department name column should only reside in the department's table. When we are using the RDBMS, we can enforce different rules on different columns. For example, we can say that the department name column should only contain unique values. Or in the first name column, there cannot be any missing or empty values. Those rules and others are called constraints. So, in summary, most of the time, when we are saying database, we actually mean the method which we are using in order to store the information. We saw that there are many kinds of methods. while the most common method is the RDBMS. But again, as I said, it doesn't mean that saving data in tables is the only database method. Remember that databases provide many benefits other than just storing our data, and as we said, the RDBMS is characterized by the concept of relating one table to another, normalized structure of tables, and constraints. That's all for this lesson. Please feel free to ask any question you may have in the comments section below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.